Tree Books and Harper Audio present Deephaven by Ethan M. Aldridge. Performed by Elena Rey. To my siblings, Erica, Hannah, Cole, and Megan, and all the strange stories we've shared over the years. Chapter 1. The great house reached out with the shadow of its spires, welcoming Guinevere Tallow with a cold embrace. Deephaven Academy had greeted many such children in the past, but today, its silent affection was reserved only for Nev. They shivered at the touch and pulled their customary dark green coat tighter around their shoulders. They never went anywhere without that coat, though it was clearly too big for them. The hem reached nearly to their knees, and its rough fabric had a comforting weight. Its many pockets were perfect for the various odds and ends that Nev was forever picking up. They'd even stitched on a few extra pockets. Beneath the coat, they wore a clean collared shirt and dark slacks that were looking a little rumpled after the long trip by train and truck, and a pair of narrow black boots. They'd purchased the clothes with the last of the money they'd hidden away after paying for their train ticket. The small tan suitcase in Nev's hand was their only luggage. There hadn't been time to pack more. Nev had needed to leave home in a hurry. They stood in the leaf-strewn drive of Deephaven Academy, listening to the sounds of the old truck that had carried them from the station fade into the distance until its rumbling cough was indistinguishable from the shush of the forest leaves. It had been a long drive, more than an hour from the town where the station was located. The driver had been waiting for them there. She'd given Nev a grim nod when they showed her the letter from the school before ushering them into the truck. They hadn't talked much along the way. Instead, Nev had watched silently as the autumn-soaked forest slid past the truck's grimy windows. Standing now in the far-flung valley, surrounded by trees and silence and evening mist, towered over by the hulking mass of the great house, Nev felt even smaller than they usually did. They ran their hand through their short, dark hair, which still curled at the edges from the recent unfamiliar cut. A new haircut, a new outfit, a new life. They'd transformed themselves on the way to Deephaven Academy, slipping into a shape more comfortable than the one they'd known. Nev intended to seize this chance. Here in this mist-shrouded valley, where no one knew them or all that had happened before. Here, they could be the person they needed to be. This was Nev's chance to finally feel comfortable in their own skin. A chance to start over. Probably their only chance. It had been an easy choice to leave everything behind and accept Deephaven's invitation. Nev's mother had vanished years before, toward the end of the Depression, unable to cope with the tiny apartment in the crowded city with too little money and too much need. After she'd gone, Nev's father had fallen apart in a different way. He threw what little money they had left into get-rich-quick schemes and bad deals with worse people. Anything that made him feel like escape was just one lucky break away. All it got him were empty pockets and angry men pounding on their apartment door. It all finally collapsed, and Nev didn't have anything to keep them home. They took a deep breath and started for the front door of the looming house. Deephaven looked exactly like the photo in the pamphlet Nev had received along with the letter. But in person, there was something off about it. The house was as sprawling and stately as had been advertised, Tall, narrow lattice windows ran along each of its floors, glinting gold in the late evening light. Old stone and peaked roofs, even a few scattered gargoyles along the corners, leered dimly out of the gathering gloom. The pamphlet had said that the school was built around what remained of a historic chapel, and it certainly looked like it. What hadn't been visible in the academy's pamphlet was how crooked the place was. Nev had a careful eye for how things fit together, and the house didn't. Corners didn't quite match up, or they ran at odd angles. It made Nev feel dizzy, as if the house were coming apart in slow motion, sinking unevenly into the surrounding earth. As their eyes took in the ancient edifice, their attention was caught by a figure in a high window, watching Nev's approach. Nev froze, gazing up at the shadowy silhouette. They couldn't make out any details through the rough window glass, but the figure looked large. Its edges were tangled and ragged, bleeding into the shadows of the house behind it. Not knowing what else to do, Nev gave a small wave. The shadow behind the glass didn't move. It simply continued to stare down at them. Its stillness was so absolute that Nev began to doubt that the shape was even a person. Perhaps it was a piece of furniture, or the ragged reflection of a tree in the surrounding forest. Nev shuddered and quickly continued forward, feeling invisible eyes tracking their every step. The front door was an imposing thing, dark wood wrapped in huge bands of iron, a clear holdover from the house's chapel days. Nev knocked, smarting their knuckles on the stiff, cold wood. The sound reverberated heavily into the space beyond. Then, there was only silence. Nev was a day early. The academic term wasn't starting until tomorrow. They had written the school in advance to let them know about their premature arrival, and while they hadn't received a response, there had been someone to pick up Nev at the train station. Nev waited a few more chilly moments, then tried the door's imposing iron handle. It was a school, after all. It wasn't as if they were barging into someone's private home. Besides, Nev reasoned, they were a student there. They belonged. That's what the letter said, anyway. The letter had arrived with the stack of usual bills and late notices addressed to their father, all of which Nev meticulously sorted. Seeing their names spelled out in a looping handwritten script on the front of the envelope had been a surprise. It had been a while since someone had sent them a letter. It had contained a pamphlet extolling the virtues of the prestigious Deephaven Academy, an image of the grand house displayed on the front. It was a small school catering to a very select crowd of talented and promising students. Looking over the included list of notable alumni, it seemed that talented and promising mostly meant rich. They'd even heard of some of the people, famous artists and politicians, scientists and engineers. An impressive school, and one far above what Nev could ever hope to afford. But then, they had read the letter that had come with the pamphlet, and then read it again, sure they'd misunderstood its message. It was an offer for a full scholarship, room and board included, granted to them in recognition of their prodigious talent and clear potential. It was signed by the principal of the school, Susan Blanchley. Nev had turned the whole packet over and over, sure it had been sent to them by mistake. Of course, it's hard to address something to a name like Guinevere Tallow by mistake. Nev had put the letter away. Their father needed them at home, not away at some mysterious boarding school. Every day had the same shape. They would wake up early and check if their father was sleeping the night off somewhere comfortable, if he had bothered to return home at all. Nev would then head to the small park near their smaller apartment, claim a spot along a well-trodden path, and spread out a colorful patchwork blanket to display the little toys they'd made to sell. Clockwork mice and wind-up rabbits, trinkets sold for souvenirs. It wasn't much, just enough to keep the landlord at bay and food in the pantry most of the time. In the evening, they'd return home, sleep, and do it again the next day. Plans, of course, changed. The door to Deephaven opened surprisingly smooth. Nev looked along the outside wall of the house, trying to see if the figure from the window above was still watching. But the window was out of sight, hidden behind the strange angles of the house. Nev stepped out of the cold and into the matching cold of the house's wide foyer, the high ceilings and long stone floor putting them in mind of the church this place had apparently once been. A massive rug, its pattern worn and faded from the passage of untold students, lay along the floor. The walls were set with gas lamps, each emitting a low hiss, warm light flickering through their fogged glass bulbs and bathing the floor in an amber glow. Nev blinked in the dim light. The apartment they'd lived in had electric light for as long as they could remember, though they supposed the technology hadn't quite made it out to the more far-flung parts of the countryside. Something about the honey-tinted glow of the gaslight settled their nerves a little. Dark wood doors lined either side of the hallway, and two sets of stairs flanked the far end, winding up into darkness. Set above the arched stone doorway Nev had just passed through was a detailed carving of a symbol that Nev recognized from the pamphlet as the school's crest, a shield emblazoned with an open book, a twig-like wand with a single leaf still attached, resting across its pages. In elegant script over the shield were the words, "Potentiale est potentia."
Hello?
Nev called. Their raspy voice echoed around the cavernous space, swallowed by the halls, until the house repeated it gently back to them. Hello? Nev shivered, feeling silly. Why were they cowering in the entryway, waiting for some adult to materialize and take their hand? They straightened their shoulders, gripping their small suitcase with one hand and digging the other into their coat pocket, and set off deeper into the house. Empty hallways branched like veins through the house, eventually leading Nev to a circular, comfortably furnished sitting room. It had a cold fireplace and a staircase winding up along the wall and out of sight to the floors above. Small tables in the sitting area held books and vases, most covered in a thin layer of dust. The flowers in the vases, however, looked fresh. It was the first sign Nev had seen that they weren't the only person to walk these halls in months. They stepped closer to examine them, finding an open sewing kit next to a vase, colored threads and rows of long needles packed inside. Without really thinking about it, Nev picked up a large silver bobbin from the box and slipped it into the inner upper right pocket of their coat with a practiced motion. Just in case, they thought. They always thought this when collecting. Nev turned back toward the sprawling emptiness of the house. And at the end of the far hall, they saw a ghost. Chapter 2. Nev's heart stuttered. The thin white thing glided smoothly down the hall toward them, stepping out of the gloom. No, not a ghost. A girl. A tall and slender girl with a pale face, pale hair, a white jacket, and a cream-colored skirt. She stared at Nev with wide green eyes in an expression of surprise that mirrored Nev's own. The girl's face split into a sudden grin. Something about the look of that smile put Nev in mind of a picture they'd seen in a book once, of a crocodile who'd just spotted an antelope on a nearby shore. "You're early," the pale girl said. She nodded toward the sewing box where Nev had just taken the bobbin. "Picking up a souvenir for your first day?"
I'm sorry, Nev said.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.